Oh, Cory, I heard you got some work for me to do today. Fix my Wi-Fi.
Tell me what's going on.
I just find that it's pretty spotty. Like, I have very good Wi-Fi. My router is decent, and I even have Verizon Fios, which gives me really good up and down speeds. And yet, calls drop out, or I can't connect to certain things, or things just get laggy and slow. I heard that science could help, but I'm gonna have to put in a little work.
We won't be able to help you on the tech side, because we are not the tech side of The Verge. As you know, you are the techie one. But what we can do is use some science and some simulations to try to figure out what exactly is going on.
Sounds easy.
Easy for us, not so much for you.
You love to hear it. Okay, where's my tape measure? Oh.
So here's the deal. If we want to figure out Becca's internet problems, we gotta start with the science of Wi-Fi, what it is and how it moves through space. At its most basic, Wi-Fi is electromagnetic radiation that we use to carry data. It's on the same spectrum as radio waves, visible light, x-rays, etc. It's actually here in the microwave band, between radio waves and infrared. Embedding data in electromagnetic waves is a crazy topic, and one for a different video. Today, we're interested in how waves get from your router to your phone or your laptop. And to understand that, we had to call in some backup.
Yeah, it can be a bit magic. It's such a complicated thing as well. Like, the fact it works at all is kind of amazing.
Jason Cole is a physicist and software engineer. A few years back, he got frustrated with his own crappy Wi-Fi, so he did some math, looked up some algorithms, and built a software simulator to diagnose the problem. He even baked it into an Android app, which we can use to predict how waves move through Becca's apartment. The basics of the app are simple enough. Drop a virtual router in a virtual room, and the algorithm will calculate wave strength at each pixel of the map.
So if you, say, had a single antenna with nothing around it, so in a vacuum, say, in space, as that current goes up and down inside the antenna, what that will cause is like a donut of radiation spreading outwards.
But Becca doesn't live in a single empty room. This is the layout of her apartment in 2D bitmap form. On the map, each pixel represents 1 centimeter. Here's her router here. And all of these colors are walls, doors, and windows of different materials. Wood, brick, glass, and concrete. The layouts and materials of those barriers are key, because whenever a wave hits a new material, a whole new dance of wave behaviors are triggered. Say the signal hits a wood door. At the boundary, some waves are reflected back, some refract in, a few could scatter across tiny variations in the wood grain, or diffract around the edge of the door. Some waves that make it inside the wood might be absorbed by the wood's atoms. Others reach the far side, but get reflected back in.
So continually as the wave propagates through, it's lowering in amplitudes, losing power, heating up the wall. You might see this in the simulations in the app as well. You can get waves kind of bouncing back and forth inside the wall.
So waves do make it all the way through and continue onto your device. But the barrier has stolen or redirected a lot of energy along the way. Now, the app doesn't simulate every possible interaction. Instead, it takes a whack at every major reflection, absorption, and diffraction of the material. But even this simpler proxy shows an incredible churn of signals bouncing all around Becca's apartment every millisecond.
You can observe a whole kind of zoo of electromagnetic phenomenon, which is kind of fun in itself.
The app also gave us our next steps with Becca. All right, you ready?
As ready as I'm gonna be.
Okay, check this out.
What? That looks like a beam of sun coming from behind my TV. That's really cool. And then my poor bedroom is just like...
dead.
That makes so much sense. I lose so many calls up there.
So the Wi-Fi is able to go through certain walls in ways that you wouldn't expect.
I'm just shook. I'm gonna start taking more calls in the shower.
Again, this is just a simulation. We would like to just see how accurate the simulation is.
Okay.
And in order to do that, it is going to take a little bit of work. But what we'd like you to do, and I dropped one of these off to you the other day.
Oh, I got one of these guys.
We'd like you to manually chart the Wi-Fi signal so that we can build a heat map.
You know, I think the simulation did a great job. I think it's answered all my questions.
You're not getting off that easy, Becca.
Oh boy, now I see why I work on the tech team.
So each one of those boxes is 2 feet by 2 feet. And for each square, you're gonna go around and give me the best and worst reading using this app. It's called Oka Speed Test. So it measures your internet signal by decibel milliwatts, DBMs, and we're gonna average them out and build an actual heat map and see how that compares to the simulation.
I think this will be the first time ever I wished my apartment was smaller. Okay, so my apartment is officially measured every 2 feet. You can see these little like blue dots behind me. So now I have a grid to reference, and I'm gonna go ahead and measure the Wi-Fi signal every 2 feet. Hey!
How was the plotting?
Plotting was, to say the least, it took a lot longer than I expected.
Did you find anything interesting?
From what I understand, there were some pockets of like good Wi-Fi and other pockets of bad Wi-Fi, but all in the same area. Like in my bedroom, for example, in the middle, I think there was like a solid pocket of signal, but then around the perimeter, not so much. And I found that very interesting, but I really didn't know what these numbers meant, so...
Well, I can show you.
Yes.
You wanna see? Okay.
I'm so excited, okay.
So we have a couple of these shots, which are really fun. We can see it live in your apartment. So like, this is your living room.
Sick! Oh my gosh, that's so cool! Anytime you put numbers in 3D space, I'm gonna be impressed, but this does make me feel like all of my hard work paid off in measuring every one of those spots.
Here's if you take a FaceTime call in the kitchen.
Wow, kitchen looks good.
And then here's the not so great bedroom.
Okay, so don't lay directly in the middle of my bed. Got it, okay.
I think the simulation did a pretty good job.
I didn't think the simulation was actually going to be correct. I thought it was just something cool to look at, but holy cow, it's like kind of spot on.
So yeah, what do you think? Are you glad you did this?
Yeah, this is super cool, but I also have some bad news. I'm moving like this weekend.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Well, we can do this in the new apartment. How's that sound?
No, we're not gonna do this in the new apartment. I can't see myself doing this ever again.
I guess maybe you can tell the next tenant not to put their router next to the brick beam.
I think this would be a real selling point to show them that even though there are walls, you'll get certain bands of good Wi-Fi in your bedroom.
So I've pretty much given up on the Wi-Fi in my own apartment. So during the week when I need faster internet, I just run this pretty unsightly Ethernet cable through my entire apartment. And it works wonders.